What's up, Scrolgers? It's Nerp here, and welcome to another video. Guys, I did it. I got my fifth first place weekly winner badge, which gets me the Minecraft cape. So if you don't know what that is, just go check on scrolls.com. There's a post a while back, like a couple weeks ago. And now I'm the third player to get five first place weekly winners. I'm joining Antirad and Nicktean16, so I'm gonna get an awesome Scrolls cape for Minecraft. So that's pretty cool. And today I'm just gonna make a video of the new daily trials. So this is what there was Fridays and there was set. This is actually just the third daily trials. I had a video of the first ones. You guys didn't see the second ones from me, and I'm gonna do the third ones in this video. I figure I'll do this because they actually just came out 11 minutes ago. So hopefully I can get this video uploaded quickly and you guys can see how I beat them in case you're having trouble. So I'll just plow through these as fast as I can. The easy one is main start with rigged. Okay, so that's interesting. The scroll says it can only be enchanted on structures, I think. Right? Enchanted structure, yeah. Wait, when enchanted structure is destroyed in melee combat, its attacker takes 4 physical damage. Does that mean that when my creature with rigged is destroyed in melee combat, the other creature won't take damage because it's not a structure? I don't know, we'll see. Who knows, maybe I won't even have anything die. And my opponent units start with a stylet advance, so it's pretty hard for my opponent to overcome. This should be easy. Let's just get this done. Hopefully I can win in like six or so rounds. I think I've beaten all the daily trials so far, all six before this of the first 2 days, in about 10 rounds or less with this deck I'm using right now, just a normal aggro growth deck. The daily trials are really, really, really easy for like new players. I mean for like experienced players, but I could see them being kind of difficult for new players, especially the hard one. Okay, like I could go up and kill him, but this is the easy AI, and I'm not worried about the easy AI. Let's go like this. So, Earthen Mirth. Okay, so now let's play the Earthen Mirth. There. That's one idle down. Yeah, I'm obviously supposed to be going after their units. Okay, so actually the creatures don't come in with rigged. Only, I guess, your structures would. Alright. And hopefully I can win on round 7. And I will. Alright, easy AI. You are very bad. Nice and quick. Let's see if I can win the medium AI pretty fast as well. So yeah, I only got 5 gold from besides the normal reward. That's how fast it was. 52 seconds. Okay, let's get to the next one. I start with 2 eternal statues, so 2 nice little walls, and my opponent's units have Pilgrim's Seat, which means they have magic armor and they'll keep healing when they move. Okay, not too bad. Use the same deck. Math is annoying, they're like in the middle of the board here. Although Terminator Vetter is great, I want to get more creatures in my starting hand, and I guess this is bad that I mulligan there. I don't think this is going to be quite as fast as a win of the other match I played, but whatever. Okay, this is actually the first time I've seen, I think. No, I've seen him play Order before. Actually, never mind. Alright, now it's a good starting hand because of this Kinfolk Brave. I don't think even though it's a 3 drop that I can play next turn, I don't think I'm going to need to play any structures for protection considering I have these 2 things. Medium AI, I kind of think maybe I should attack these guys. I don't know. Oh, actually, that's annoying. These guys can kill my dudes. Let's get rid of the Stag Heart. Play the Earthorn Mystic. Actually, yeah, I'm gonna take him out. Because I don't want to just lose my brave. That's annoying. Okay, then. I'm gonna get rid of the veteran for scrolls and just play better. I don't really just want to enchant this guy because he'll just be immediately destroyed by the Sinmark Zealot. So we'll see if the Sinmark Zealot blows itself up and kills him. No, sure, it's the Vetter. Okay, that's an interesting choice the AI made. Alright. And... I guess I'll sacrifice one of the Great Wolves. I'd rather not have to do that, but whatever. Oh, I didn't have to. I could have just drawn an enchantment from you. Earth and Mirth, please. Nah. Yeah, I made a little bit of misplay there. Should have kept the other Great Wolf and sacrificed the stag card that I would have drawn. I wanted to get rid of this stupid totem. I'll just take you out. Yeah, this trial is taking a lot longer. Already on round 6 and I haven't even destroyed any idols yet. I can't even put two things on this row to get rid of you. Let's get rid of the Great Wolf. Let's rumble. Actually, I can do it with the veteran. I'm just going to play the veteran. And give me an Earth and Mirth. Nice. Alright. Yeah, I've been taking out my opponent's units in one shot. So the Pilgrim's Feet hasn't really done much for him. Okay. Now it's time we start doing bigger things. Can we win next turn? Okay, was he gonna push back to you? Alright, now we can't win this turn. Let's see. Let's play the Mirth on you. Okay, let's just go like that. Well, but it looks like I'll still win by round 10, or I'll win on round 10. Yep, I'll slow win. See, the AI does not really protect its idols too well. Alright. So, yeah, I got more gold for that one. And now let's beat this hard one. Totem Mask Unground. So that means my units will start... That's actually pretty, this is... Might be pretty difficult because if my units are on ground, it means as I attack the idols, my units are gonna die. And Totem Mask means that they're gonna get pretty strong when I start playing structures. My opponent starts with Blast Strike and 3 resources. I don't know if this is gonna be hard or not, we'll see. I could make like a specialized deck for this, but we'll see how it goes. I haven't lost any of these yet, so hopefully. It's okay. Wait. My units start with Unground. That's actually a huge, like, hindrance. Right? I think it is. I'm not gonna play the Brave yet. Elder. My units are on ground. Should I have played like a structure deck? I don't know. Let's see. And you're gonna take damage. How do I do this? I I don't think I approached this correctly. Because I'm gonna lose my creatures. Yeah, these are the unground. You know, I'm not gonna be able to win this with my current deck. Oh, there's my first loss to a, something like stupid bug. Doesn't surrender yet. I'm not gonna be able to win with this kind of deck. So there's my first loss in a trial. In a, daily trial, I mean. And that was weird, it kind of froze for a second. But I think, what should I do? Should I play structure? I have to play something with like direct elbow damage, I guess. I don't know. How did I beat that? Structure energy, but would the AI just stay away from playing Metal Wonders, from playing spells? I don't know. All my units start with Unground. I guess I can just like Faith Chains my way to victory or something. Yeah, let's just start with this first. Metal Wonder. And I'll take out, and I'll take out the AI probably won't play around Thunder Surge. Maybe they will. Take out the Thunder Surges and put in a Giant. Okay. I'll delete that afterwards. Okay. Whoops. Tutorials. Yeah, I already did all the tutorials. Okay. Let's see. Metal Wonders. It will stop the AI from playing things. I don't understand how to do this. Okay. Double charge coil sounds like a plan. I guess I could have just sparked that. Forge for him. Okay, my charge coils are gonna be pretty healthy. I think just one Metal Wonder is gonna be enough for my opponent to stop playing spells, knowing the AI and its weird antics. Okay. And No, I'd rather have this other stuff. Let's go for scrolls. Let's just play another charge coil. Alright, hopefully these things start pinging him to death. Pace through energy. Okay. Get rid of the potion of resistance, I guess. And I'll play a forge. Okay, so this is, I guess, good. I don't know. Thea. We're gonna need something to get rid of the Thea. That's gonna deal a lot of damage to the idol, and then we're gonna get hurt a lot. Alright, sudden eruption. It's pretty good. Okay, let's play that. That'll be it. Okay. So now how do we... Okay, the Thea, what's the Thea gonna do? I'd rather him attack my structures than the idols. Him attacking my structures hurts less than him attacking my idols. Okay. Let's get rid of the sudden eruption. I can deal 4 damage as long as the machine chant. It's not really enough, is it? I don't know. Let's put this here and lure the Thea to hit it. Okay, so now I take Athea with Sheen Chant, which is good. Is Athea gonna hit the idol right there? Whoa. And she's probably gonna move down there. Maybe? Yeah. Okay. So now I have to take things out. I guess I'll take that out. And get rid of that for scrolls. Okay. Man, unground on everything is kind of tough. Ow. Let's see. Let's get rid of the... Sudden Eruption. Just get rid of this stupid Thea. Nice. Now, hopefully that Aether Pump can go off. He just pumps. And we're good. Okay. Let's see. Honestly, I think it's really important that we get rid of the Storm Runner right now. Like, right now. Let's do it. And that will be that. Okay. Now what? Don't play another Thea though, please. Giant. Ugh, I have to waste turns like trying to get rid of those things. Okay. Oh god, that just hurts so much. Need to play structures like faster. I don't know what to do here. Okay, burn. I'm gonna stop him from hitting my idols. My idols are just too valuable. I can't let him touch my idols. I have to have those ether pumps go off. Another elder crap. Bombard, oh god. No, that ether pump goes down. Ugh. Really, why is the hard AI being good? Hard AI is supposed to suck. Okay. I need like 1,000 structures. Let's get rid of this thing. Let's get rid of that. Let's hurt everything a little bit. Okay. At least once those idols go down, I'm not, like, threatened by them. Really, he knows to... Oh, he just burns. Thought he was gonna, like, know to do that. Okay, why don't I have freaking Thunder Surges in this deck? Overdrive. Good. That's, like, kind of perfect. I don't know what I do here. I guess I have to protect. Okay. Worst thing he could do to me is... Oh, he had lethal! He had lethal. I guess that hurts. But he had lethal that turn. Alright. So that is going to do good things. And I'm gonna get. Another one of these here. Another one of these here. Oh no, that's gonna. This thing hurts me. My Oculus Cannon. He's making it go off. He's just gonna bombard for the win. Ugh. How do I do this? This trial is insane. Oh god. I don't know what I'm doing right now. I'll be completely honest with you. Okay. Oh no, this is gonna go down. Come on. Well, this is gonna hurt me a little bit, but whatever. And a clock library. I'm just playing with all this stuff just so I can like survive, because every time I play structure, my structure's health goes way up. Actually, by having my idols get hurt so much, I think I'm actually okay here. All my structures are gonna take 4 damage. I'll just play this here. I need to increase this thing's health. Oh no, it's only 2 damage maybe, because the idol only had 2 health. Okay, 2 more idols here. If he moves on this row, that's really bad for me. Because this, I don't want this to attack. I honestly don't want that to attack. Uh-oh. My structures are only gonna take 4 damage maximum. Okay. It's not the worst thing in the world. Do I do the overdrive right now to see what I get? I don't know. No structures. That's not good. Let's see. Let's overdrive. No, it destroyed it! Oh god! What have I done? I just, like, lost the game for me. Oh, I may have just lost the game for me. I destroyed my clock library. Okay. Well, at least I have a sudden eruption for this. Let's get rid of that. We just need to have 1, 2, 3, 4. So I'm gonna have 8. I'll just play that and sudden eruption. Okay, I need to somehow. I don't know how to do this. I don't know how I'm gonna lose though, because I'm gonna keep playing structures. I kinda want all 3 of these cards. I'm gonna actually post some resistance this, because if he had a Valence Sorcerer, he could actually win. This is a 20. Look at this. This Oculus Cannon has 24 attack and 15 health. Really? Really? A Thunder Surge on a useless contraption? Okay. Charge Coil. Good burn. So let's stop him from playing spells now. I know he's gonna be afraid to play spells. I just know it. I'll just play my structures over there. Okay. So as long as we stop him from doing idle damage, we'll be okay. We have to somehow find a way to win, though. Okay, we just did a little bit of idle damage there. Oh, by the metal wonder is dealing one damage to all my structures. Oh my god, Unground is crazy. This is actually kind of fun, though. Okay, let's play some of this stuff. And I don't know, I don't want you going around. Nice. Alright, you have 11 attack. Okay, I need to get a Psalm Giant. Okay. Psalm Giant, please. Well, not anymore. Chain Chant. Sudden Eruption, sure. Okay, we cleared the board. This thing has 32 freaking attack. I'm really mindlessly playing right now, guys. So if you want to beat this hard draw, just mindlessly play Structure Energy. Just put down structures as you get them, and they just have such high health, not even giant ungrounds can destroy them. Well, let's continue to put stuff down. Okay. I wonder at what point he's gonna stop playing spells. Maybe he already stopped. Burn. Fine, burn that. Oh boy, bombard. Okay. Doesn't really matter too much. I do take a lot of damage to all the blast strike and everything. Solemn Giant, is that GG? That is GG. Guys, wait, he's gonna kill himself too. That is how you beat the hard trial. GG. GG. Was that worth it? I don't know. For 877 gold, not too bad. So, hopefully you guys can beat it a little faster. So thank you all for watching, like if you enjoyed, subscribe for more content like this, and I have an urge to play Minecraft just to show off my new cape. But yeah, so thanks for watching, I'll see you guys next time.